And joining us now from Nashville with the latest on the search is Mark Gwynn, director of the Tennessee Bureau of Investigation. Mr. Gwynn, good morning.
Good morning.
Day five. So where is the investigation headed today?
Well, we have over 250 leads that we're looking at. We also have a good bit of evidence that's being analyzed at the TBI crime lab right now. And we've also engaged the community and asked for their support and their help. So I think we're on the right track. It's just going to take for something to come in and really take us to the next level in the investigation.
If you could just clarify something for us. I know there have been some conflicting reports the last couple of days, whether Holly was either dragged into the woods. The new report is that she was led into the woods, whether it was potentially her boyfriend or not her boyfriend. Her brother was an eyewitness to all of this. Can you clarify why the story has changed here the last few days?
Well, we don't believe that Holly was dragged into the woods. We think based on her brother, who is the only witness, that she walked into the woods. As far as suspects, we have not eliminated anyone from this investigation. Obviously, there are people who we feel are witnesses and we've treated as such, but we have not eliminated anyone, and that's why we asked the community to really look amongst themselves. This is a very rural area, a very wooded area, and someone would have had to known how to navigate around the area, either a hunter or a resident or something of that nature, in order to be able to exit and enter like they did.
So what you are saying here, though, is that the brother and the boyfriend have not been ruled out as suspects. They're still suspects in this investigation.
There has nobody been ruled out of this investigation. We have not got tunnel vision and ruled anybody out. Everybody at this point, based on the evidence that we have, based on the leads that we have, could potentially be a subject.
Let me ask you something. When time is of the essence, and it's so critical, especially in the early stages of an investigation like this, do eyewitness accounts that vary so greatly, does that impede your ability to try to find Holly?
Well, you know, obviously you would like to have all of your witnesses and eyewitnesses to give you the same story in a perfect world, but that rarely happens. So basically what you have to do is take all your evidence, collect it, analyze it, and you've got to take the evidence you've got to take the investigation where the evidence is going to lead you.
Mr. Gwynn, thank you. We appreciate you taking the time this morning.
Thank you.
If you have any information on the whereabouts of Holly Bobo, please call 1-800-TBI-FIND. That's 1-800-TBI-FIND.